All right, what's up, guys? So I'm gonna show you a little bit of a little bit of a tweak to the bass line and the guitar part that y'all were doing at our Thrive lessons. So the three notes that you had been playing was this on the fourth fret on the lowest string. You do that one again. So that's the first note and the second note. The third one was here, fourth fret on the next string up. And then the last note was here on fret two, the bottom string. So those notes aren't going to change. You're going to still play all those notes. We're just going to add a couple little things in the spaces. So the first note goes like this, just like normal. And the second note. And here's the first new part. So that's six on your A string right here. And then four and six on the D string. So that goes like this. And then you go right to the third note, you already know. And then there, two, three, four, back to the last note like you're used to. One, two, three, four, and then right before we go back to the first note again, you're going to do this. And that's on the fourth fret on the D string. So I'm going to put that all together real quick. One, two, three, four. Time. Okay, so that's the whole loop. Hey guys, what's up? I'm going to show you how to play a little bit more of a complicated guitar part than what you guys were doing last night. And it basically follows the same three notes that you were doing. Fret 4 for note 1 and 2, so you hit that one two times. And then you have your third note here, fret 4 on the A string, and then you have your last note here, fret 2 on the low string. Now we're just going to add a couple things in between some of these notes to make the part more complicated. So we're going to hit the first note here, one, two, three, four. And the second note, one, two, and then go to the next note, the third note. So the thing I added was this. And how you play that is fret six on the A string, fret four on the D string, and fret 6 on the D string. So it should sound like this. And then you go to the third note, which you already knew. And then you go to the fourth note. And we're going to add that right before we go back to the beginning. And that's going to be fret 4 on the D string. So putting that whole thing together goes like this. One, two, three, four. So let's try putting it with the music. Alright, so now let's put what I just showed you guys in context with the actual song.
Crazy little thing, little pain, and you just guessed. As the fire
and so forth. Alright, cool. So, this right here is called a capo, and it helps us as guitar players play certain chords a little bit easier. So, we're going to put this clamp right here on fret 4. So when you guys get yours, go ahead and do what I just did. Open it up, put it right over the strings, make sure they aren't getting bent, and just clamp it down. Now, fret 1, instead of being here and fret 2 being here, fret 1 is here, fret 2 is here, fret 3, and so on and so forth. So the chords that you guys can play, in addition to that bass line and guitar line that I just showed you, can be done like this. Okay, so here's how we do these shapes. The first chord, you're going to use these three fingers, your middle finger, your ring finger, and your pinky finger. You're going to place each one, respectively, on the A string, the D string, and the G string, just like this. So you have an open low string, and then the next three are held down by your fingers. The top two strings are open and not being held down by anything. So you strum all of that. Now we're going to release our pinky finger and put our pointer finger down on fret 1 on the G string, going from here to here. You should really hear that color change to know you're doing it right. Now, the next chord change is pretty easy. We're going to lift off our ring finger, and we're going to move these two fingers parallel down to the next two strings, going from here to here. So now we have an open A string, fret 2, an open G string, and fret 1. You strum that together to make that chord. So the first three go like this. And the very last chord is a D chord, and it goes like this. You have your pointer finger on fret 2 on the G string, your ring finger on fret 3 on the B string, and your middle finger is on fret 2 on the very highest string. And that sounds like that. So the whole part you guys can play goes like this. And that's it. Back to the beginning.
Do it one more time.
Cool. I'll do it one more time like this, and then I'll put it with the song. Like that. So let's put it with the song. That's it, guys. Practice hard.